We have a lot to get to tonight, but I want to get started with NBC2's Hope Salmon. She is live at one of the hardest hit areas in Lee County, the Cottage Point Mobile Home Park. Hope spoke with a man who says he's lucky to be alive after getting trapped inside his home. Hope, how's he doing tonight?
Christy, he is doing so much better. I feel like I can finally smile for the first time today because he was reunited with his dog, Coco. She was actually found right up there in that room. Somebody, one of the neighbors, just found the dog and was able to contact him and reunite them. And he says he's doing well tonight. He's actually going to be at a friend's house for the next couple of days. And I just want to show you what it looks like out here. I mean, the community just... it just brings so much joy to my heart to see how much of this is cleaned up. There were clothing items. There were Christmas decorations. All of this man's life was laid out here on the floor, and the community has helped him pick it up. All that's left now is just this terrible situation where the house completely flipped over. And we didn't get a chance to show you this earlier, so I'm going to take you to kind of the other side here, and we'll give you a better look in just a minute. But this mobile home actually toppled on top of another mobile home, and that's the roof of the second one, and those people live there. Now, they did not want to go on camera. Obviously, they're working very hard to fix their home, but they tell me that they were worried for their lives. And the situation here seems to be getting a little better, but it's going to take days, maybe even months, to have things look like normal. The storms have passed, but the community is left picking up the pieces.
It almost threw me through the wall with that. The house was turning over.
Edward Murray was stuck in the middle of the storm. This is the aftermath of what his home looks like, completely uprooted.
I was trapped in a little area, like in a fetus position. I couldn't move.
Edward says he was trapped in his home for at least 30 minutes, waiting for someone to help him out. Luckily, his neighbor called for help.
We came out and saw all this.
And I can look at this pile of rubbish and know that people were willing to help.
He and his daughter were able to make it out. Edward's dog, Coco, was missing for a while, but someone found her in the rubble.
It was just great, just fantastic. Thank you, thank you, and thank God.
This neighborhood sits right next to the Sanibel outlet stores. A woman down the street woke up to her windows breaking.
It was terrifying just to hear everything cracking and snapping and grass flying past your head.
This is what her garage looks like now, missing its roof. And while we were driving on the Sanibel Causeway, we were almost caught in the storm. Here is video of the funnel we saw. So you can just see that it was a wild ride all day here today, and we are just so glad that everyone, at least in that home, was doing well. Christy?
Hope, it's so heartbreaking to see all that destruction behind you. I mean, it's like a big mountain really behind you, and you know, thankfully, Edward made it out of his house alive. Thankfully, his dog made it out alive, but Edward was definitely not the only person impacted in this community.
Yeah, Hope, if you could actually walk us through what other damage you're seeing out on that street right now while you're out there.
Yeah, of course. So over here, there is still a lot more damage. As you can see, many of the palms are down, trees are down. You can see how people have started to kind of organize all of this debris. And there are many other homes down that road that have either missing roofs, missing garages. Just so many things are out of place right now. It's really hard to just show and describe in just a couple minutes. It's just really... a lot of cleanup out here, for sure.
It seems like a chaotic scene out there, Hope. Thank you so much.